Hey guys, so this time I decided to make a bee house, which is different than a beehive. And I'm learning all this. This is all kind of new to me, but bee houses are preferred by solitary bees, and solitary bees include things like leaf cutters, masons, and carpenter bees. I got the plan from a book from my favorite woodworking author, Mr. A.J. Hamler. He has a book called Birdhouses and More. And I'll put a link to where you can find the book that has the plan out on my website at woodlogger.com. But coming up in the video, I'll show you how I made mine. It's a pretty easy project. It's a single 2x6 is all you need. I've got kind of a simple piece of scrap that I use for a roof. And then drilled various holes into the sides of the boards. Used a spade bit with this, a 1/4 inch and a 5/16 inch, and I think it turned out pretty well. Not real happy with the stain that I put on there, and honestly, you don't need to put stain on it. I've been going a little nuts with stain lately on a lot of my projects, and I'm not real happy with the way this one turned out, but I am real happy with the overall the house itself. So anyways, coming up in the video, I'll show you how I made this, and be sure to check out my website out at woodlogger.com, where I'll post more information about this project and other projects that I have going on in my shop. So to get started on my bee house, I've got a scrap piece of 2x6. In fact, all the lumber that I'm going to use in this project came from scrap wood. So I'm going to cut this to a length of 8 inches long. It's the actual width of a 2x6 is 5.5 inches. I'm going to use my miter saw for that. I'm going to cut 4 of these, but you can certainly use a handsaw or anything you have. So I've got my block saw cut. I did 8 inches long on each of these. Next up, I'm going to use an exterior rated glue and apply that pretty liberally all over both sides of the board. Then I'll use clamps to hold these together until it's all glued up, and then I'll be ready to drill my holes next. So I've got my block of wood all glued up now, and while I was waiting for that to dry, I went ahead and drew a set of grid lines across my boards. I'm going to space the holes that I'm going to drill here in just a minute about 1 inch apart. You know, looking at the plan that I've got, it says that it's safe for the bees to do 3/4 of an inch to 1 inch. And then also because different solitary bees like different size holes, specifically mason and leaf cutter bees, they prefer 1/4 inch and 5/16 inch. So I've got a couple spade bits. I'm going to work on drilling these in. They're probably going to be just a smidgen over 4 inches in length, or in depth rather. And I'm going to go and work on that next. Okay, so I've got all my holes drilled. I think that turned out pretty good. Next up, I'm going to put the roof on the top of my bee house. I've got a piece of cedar here, and I cut it just long enough so that there'd be a slight overhang on both sides as well as the front. Now, I'm going to use 1-inch brad nails for mine, but you can certainly use any kind of nail or even screws if you want it to. So anyways, I'm going to work on that next. So I've got the roof on. I think it looks pretty good. I'm actually putting some stain on it right now, and I think I may even put a sealer on it. So, but that's certainly an optional step. So anyways, check out my website at woodlogger.com. I'll post more detailed information about this project and how I made it, as well as other projects that I have going on in my shop.